Hello, welcome to PBH Configuration Part 2. For my Part 1, I was installed the software PBH called Isabel. We have done, right? We have done the the installation. Actually, let me repeat again. For soft PBH, you can use any flavor. I'm using Isabel. You can use either free PBH, elastics, and so on. Okay, so yeah, we can start the configuration. I will start the PBH server. And we use clients in my Windows 10 and also I will try to use on my smartphone as well to communicate to each other. But first of all, I would like to install the SSH. So that if any configuration, I can remote. I no need to use the VMware directly. Okay, let me install SSH. Remember my previous password was 12345. Okay, then I install SSH, sorry, open SSH server YAM install. Okay, I forgot to tell you, before you install any packages, you need to do update first. All Linux, after you install the OS, you need to do update. Okay, if you don't do update, you cannot install any, I can say you cannot install any packages because of the I think because of the version. Okay, they are updating the version. Okay, so to do update, you just go for YAM update. Because I already updated, so it will say nothing to update, or maybe have some files to update, it will be announced. For the first update, we'll be taking around 30 minutes, I think. Yeah, 30 minutes. So for my OS, I already updated. So it say no packages marked for update. So remember to update first before you install anything. Okay, so after I install, I need to edit the file SSH. Okay, if you want to know how to enable SSH on Linux more detail, you can watch my another video. Okay, so yeah, I think we have done configuration enabling SSH. Next, I will set up the static IP address for the server. Okay, because I don't want to use this IP address. Actually, this IP address 192.168.16.125, it's coming from my router. So why I have the same rank with my Windows 10. So let's see my Windows 10, sorry. Let's see my Windows 10 IP address. It's 16.130, it's the same range. Why I got the same range? Because I use my server as the VMnet 3, which is custom. This custom network, I'm using VMnet 3, which I pointed to my network adapter. Okay, my network adapter, which is I'm also using with Windows. So I think if you want to know how to point the adapter, just watch my another video, which I copy the link below. Okay, so let me choose the address for my server. Let's say 16.16. Okay, let's say 16.16. So I go for editor. I'm familiar with VI. Okay, if you familiar with another editor, you just go ahead. So I'm familiar with VI /etc sysconfig / network script, and then the interface ifcfg.eth0. Okay, currently it is DHCP, it means DHCP client. So I don't want to use DHCP, I just say none. And below I will type IP address 192.168.16.16. And then my prefix network will be 24. Okay, and my gateway will be 192.168.16.1. And DNS, I just go for Google DNS. Okay, that's it. Then I save the file. Okay, and then I restart the network service. Systemctl restart network. Okay, let me check the IP address. Is it applied? Yes, it applied. Okay, you see 192.168.16.16 is my server. Okay, let me ping from my Windows 192.168.16.16. Yes, now we can ping to the server. Okay, we can ping to the server. So let's forget about the Linux in VMware. Okay, let's forget about VMware. If you want to remote here, you can also remote by using PuTTY. Okay, you also can remote by using PuTTY because we already enable SSH. Okay, let me try 192.168.16.16. You see, and then you just type the username and the password. Okay. That's it. Now let me open web browser and we start configuration of the PBX. So we type in the address 192.168.16.16. Okay, and then our username will be admin, the password 12345. And this password you added during installation, so please remember. So I don't want to save. Here is the GUI configuration on Isabel. So the first thing you need to do is create its extension. Okay, create extensions. As you see here in the diagram, you can have extension for IP phone, and you have extension for computers, for laptop, and for smartphone. In smartphone, you can use soft PBH, either laptop or computer. You can use soft PBH. So I will test it on my computer and my smartphone using soft PBH because I'm currently don't have IP phone. Okay, so go back to web browser, and this the web interface configuration. So first of all, you need to go to PBH, and then you go to PBH configuration. Yes, PBH configuration, and then you click on extensions. These extensions it mean that you need to create extension for clients. The example, as you seen here, this is one extension, this is one extension, one extension. So the number can be 101, 102. You cannot start with zero. Okay, you cannot start with zero. Okay, so after you click on the extension, you click on submit. Okay, you need to, let me explain, you need to use generic zip device. Okay, and then click submit. And this extension, you can type any number you like. Example, like in the diagram, if you want to use 101, let's say 101. Okay, and who is it belong to? 101, let's say Bunta is belong to 101. Okay, Bunta is belong to 101. And yes, and then you move down. Okay, there's nothing configuration in zip extension. There's only user extension and display name, and then the password. So this is the generic password you could not remember. So remove it and use the one that you can remember. And the password must be 6 character onward. Okay, so maybe I can use let's say hello at 1 2 3 4 5. Okay, let's do this, and then you scroll down, submit. Okay, now you have one extension, so I can have another extension. Okay, you can click apply change, but I will apply change after I create another extension. Let's say 102. Let's say WeChat, and then the password. I can use the same password. Okay, I will use the same password and then save. Let's say if you want to record a call, let's say you want to record inbound call extension to extension. If you want to record outbound call, if this extension call outside, you can record. Okay, you can record. Submit. So now I have two extensions. So let me test for these two extensions. Okay, I have two extensions. So we can monitoring by clicking on operator panel. You see, we have two extensions. So this extension, you can see the yellow color. It's mean that it's not connecting. So these two extension is not connecting. But if you see the orange color on the extension number, it means you are connecting. So let me try to register on my computer. I'm using iBeam. So this is my I-beam. Okay, you click on menu, go to SIP account, and then you click add many accounts as you like. As currently, I already have another account, but I disable it already. So let me add another account for connecting to our PBX. Let's say Bunta. Username 101. Okay, the password is hello at 12345. Authorize username also 101. And then if you have outgoing call, you also need a proxy address. Let's say the proxy address also the 192.168.16.16, and the domain will be your server address as well, 16.16. okay, and then you click OK, close. It is trying to register. Now it's registered successfully, 101. Okay, so let's go back to our browser. You see the orange, it means that you are connected. Okay, you are connected right now. So let me go back to my I-beam. This is my I-beam, soft PBX. I am using 101 extension. Name is Bunta. So one extension already connected. So let me go to my smartphone as well. Okay, on my smartphone, I will use Zoiper. You can use any soft PBX, okay? But I found Zoiper. So open Zoiper on your smartphone. And the username is 102, okay? The password is hello at 12345, and then create account. The host name will be your server address, 192.168.16.16. Okay, next. Then authentication username 102. The proxy let, like I told you, if you have outgoing call, you need an address, okay? 16.16. Next. You see it's found SIP account, found SIP UDP protocol. So when I click finish, you will see 102 WeChat is connected. So let me click finish. You see 102 is also connected and our Zoiper is connected. So let me try to test a call. I'm going to type 101 and then I call. You see, WeChat is calling, okay? WeChat is calling. If I'm calling from my computer to my smartphone, okay? 102 here. 102, then I call. You see? You see the, let me disable my ringtone. Okay, let me call again. Let me call again. And I disable my ringtone. Let me call to WeChat again. You see? It's ringing. If I say answer, hello. Hello, hello. Yeah, you see, Let me turn on speaker. How can I turn on speaker? Oh, because I'm using Bluetooth, maybe. Yeah, speaker. Hello? Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Yeah. You see, we can communicate to each other. Okay. So this is how we implement PBH. Okay. So I think that's all for today, and I hope you enjoy the configuration of PBits. So have a nice day.